Okay, so this video is kind of an extra kind of video to talk about once you have the digital images that you want to print and bring into the real world, what do you need to know in order to make them look good, to present them for critique? And this would be the same if you were submitting them to a show, right? So what we're going to do is use black mats for our critiques. And the reason we use black mats is because they're the most standardized. That means if you get a black mat from one store and one from another store, they're going to match pretty well. They might not be exactly right. Whereas white mats are really different from each other, right? And we just want something clean and professional looking. We also don't want to spend a lot of money, right? So you can always buy a custom mat and have a black mat cut to your exact specifications, but you're going to pay a lot more for that because you're paying for a whole mat board. And then you're paying for the labor, the specialized labor of cutting a window with a beveled blade the size you want, right? So it's a much better deal to just buy pre-cut black mats. And so pre-cut black mats are available at all the stores that are on your supply list locally. And you can get them online as well. Just make sure you have time to actually get them. And the way they work is they're standard sizes. So the smallest standard size I want you to get is 11 by 14 on the outside and 8 by 10 on the inside. That 11 by 14 on the outside is what gets cut out of your medium size that you might want to get. And so this is just how the mat makers and the framers and the art sellers of the world get as much value out of their mat board as possible, right? So the next standard size has an 11 by 14 window size. And it's a 16 by 20 outside size. And if you wanted to go bigger, because we can print up to 16 by 20, you could even get a mat with a 16 by 20 window and an 18 by 24 outside, right? But those are about the biggest you get. The most common are the small mats that we use here, which are perfect for printing your logo, and the medium mats, right? So we need to know what paper sizes we have that we can print in the lab. So the most standard paper size is just letter size. So if I draw a rectangle here and I fill it with white and then I give it a stroke of, let's do it a gray, that shows us, I'm gonna give it a little bit thicker stroke, that shows us a regular 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. Right? So an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper, or I could do it like this with a drop shadow. Ooh, very nice. And I'll make that drop shadow black. So you're seeing all these logo coloring skills come into play here. And then I don't need the stroke so much. So there we go. And I'm going to use this document and put it into links so you can refer to it for our final as well. Okay, so we have our 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. Now notice that 8.5 by 11 is not the same as any of these window sizes. So if you print something on an 8.5 by 11 piece of paper, What mat would you get for it of the options here?
11 by 14.
So if you got the 11 by 14 mat for it, look what would happen to your piece of paper. Whoops. I need to be on auto select here. So I'm actually going to size this correctly within the proportions of what we have. So this is about what an 8.5 by 11 piece of paper looks like. So it's too big for that mat, right? But it's also too little for an 11 by 14 opening. So what you need is a mat that's a little bit too small in its opening for your printing paper. And this makes perfect sense because you need to be able to take that piece of paper and then tape it behind the mat. Right? But it means your printable image on that paper is limited to what is on the map. So let's see, how can I show that to you? So this is the printable size that's going to show on your print. And I'm going to fill that with middle gray. I have to do it on a new layer. That up above. All right, so now if I take my 8x10 piece of paper right here, or I'm sorry, it's 8.5x11 piece of paper. So obviously that overlaps the 8x10 frame a little bit, and that is good. So that's our most standard. But it means when you print, you have to keep in mind that you don't want to print it all the way to the edges, because only what's within 8x10 will show. And to actually give you the actual sizes, it says it's 8x10 as a window cutout, but it's really a half inch less than that. And that's because they want to ensure, all the mat manufacturers want to make sure that you don't have white gaps at the edges of your photo or of your print. So what this dimension really is 7.5 inches on the inside by 9.5 inches. And so what should we call that? That's the actual size. I'm going to make that smaller. Not that small. And we'll make that all red. All right. That has to do with whether you use that 8x10 window with the 11x14 outside in a portrait format or in a landscape format, right? Now, what if you want to print bigger than 7.5x9.5 inches? Then you're going to go to a larger mat size, but you also need a larger piece of paper. So the next paper size we have is actually 11x19 inches. No, I'm sorry, it's 13x19 inches, which is a strange size, right? So I'm going to grow that paper over here. It's a little bit longer and narrower, and it's our medium paper size. So let me put those sizes there. 13x19 inches, and you can get that from the lab. It's our medium paper, but that's the paper you need to use if you want to fill an 11x14 window. And it's good for magazine layouts like 11x17, that kind of thing. Now again, the printable area of that is only the 11x14 printable area that you could show in this mat. And it's not actually 11x14. Instead, it's closer to 10.5x13.5. And I have that written up on the board. So this is the actual printable area on this larger piece of paper. These are our options. So let me put that information here, because this is the paper. So 8.5x11 inches. This is what's called letter size. and this is 13 by 19 inches. And this is what's called Super B size. Okay, but you have a third option. If you want to go bigger than an image that's 11 by 14, we can go up to 17 by 22 inches in our lab. Move the letter size over here. Move its printable size over there, right? And so 17 by 22 inches is what's called, actually, I don't even think it has a name. It's just the biggest we can print. So I'm going to put that on its side here, because this might be perfect for your landscape projects. And this is bigger than even the outside dimensions, right? It's bigger even than the 16 by 20 outside dimensions of that mat. So let me give us a little bit more space. All right. You can see making a little infographic here for all the mats and paper sizes. So in order for this to actually be 17 by 22, I have to grow it a little bit more and shrink it a little bit this way. That looks about right. So a 17 by 22 piece is where you can print up to 16 by 20. And 16 by 20 is basically what the outside dimensions are of the medium mats. Now, what's great about the 17 by 22 inch, we use an Epson velvet paper, like a high-end fine art paper. So even though it's the most expensive paper, it's heavy weight enough that you don't actually need to mat it in order for it to be good for the student show or for our gallery. So to me, it's good enough to show in the classroom without matting it as well, because those mats can get quite expensive. And when mats get larger than 16 by 20, they get kind of floppy and they actually are more easily damaged than the smaller mats. So your three options, small, medium, and large. These are your paper sizes, but you have to decide the mat that best suits the needs. And this is Epson fine art velvet paper. Now, we do need to use Epson brand paper for all of our print jobs, because we have Epson R1900 printers and P800 printers, and they just put out so much ink to get the high resolution images that off-brand paper like HP paper, Canon paper, they just get saturated with the ink, and so your image comes out really muddy, and also the paper loses its structural integrity. So if I just put copy paper through that and we printed a high-res print job, it would just come out as shredded, you know, sopping wet, messy tissue paper. So we need the Epson paper, but we're gonna get really good results from it. So I'm hoping everyone will be happy. So what I'm gonna do to make my color logo print ready, right, is I'm gonna make sure its image size is 8x10x350, knowing that the actual mat will come in a quarter inch on each side, because the actual mat is 7.5x10.5x9.5. So I like to put little guides there. And then I can save this as print ready. So I say save as, I put PR in front of it, save it to the desktop as my color logo print job, and save